Okay, so in today's episode, we're down at Seco. Now, Seco are our tooling partners. They're helping us apply their knowledge of the industry and aviation to what we're producing and developing. Now, it's over the last couple of days, they've been cutting the titanium compressor. Now, this is the first titanium compressor that has been cut. So let's go inside to see what's developed over the last couple of days. Now, Seco are applying their industry knowledge to our cutting strategy for the titanium. Okay. So what they've found is that this particular grade of titanium requires a high coolant pressure in order to chip the material away as it's being cut. Now, the other thing they've found is that this grade of titanium causes a lot of erosion on the tooling. Now, the other thing to understand is that in CNC machining, you've got two main inputs. You've got cut depth and you've got your speed and feed. Now, your speed and feed is where how fast your cutter travels through the material and how quickly the material is being spun or the spindle is spinning the cutter. Now, logically, if you increase your speed and feed, you're going to be putting more temperature into your cutter, into the material, and that's not necessarily what you want.
So one of the defining characteristics of Hill Helicopters and the way we're bringing HX50 to market is our vertical integration manufacturing strategy. So this idea that we can bring raw material in from one side of the factory, add the maximum value that we possibly can here, and send a premium high technology product out the other door. And nowhere is that more evident than in the GT50 engine and in things like our gears and bearings and things that make up the gearboxes, the drivetrain, and those sorts of components within the aircraft. Vertical integration is really important in controlling your development timescales, your costs, your spare prices for spare parts into the future. But becoming an organization that's able to produce these really high technology parts is a massive journey in its own right. And it's something that we have to do in parallel with the development of the aircraft and the engine itself, so that we can be sure that once the development is complete, once we've got all of the type approvals in place and a working aircraft, we're ready to seamlessly then move into production. Now, one of the key areas that we're vertically integrated is the precision engineering that we do here. So the manufacturing of precision metalwork, so gears, bearings, shafts, all of the flight control systems, and importantly, the turbomachinery elements within the engine, the compressor, the blisks, the turbines, the nozzles, all those sorts of things. Now, in order to produce those components, you're working with some of the most high performance and difficult to cut and work materials that exist anywhere in industry. And to be able to rapidly get to the point where you're delivering components in those materials at the highest possible levels of precision and integrity requires a great deal of development work in its own right. And so what we're doing is we're bringing together all of the expertise that you need to be able to rapidly push ourselves up the learning curve to the point where we can deliver these reliably, quickly, and cost effectively. Now, the expertise that you need to be able to produce these parts, part of that comes from our in-house team, our design engineers, our metallurgists, our CAM programmers and production engineers that know how to get the best out of these machines. But we also need to form partnerships with the people that supply the machine tools themselves, their application engineers, and importantly, the tooling suppliers that provide the tooling topologies that we use, the tooling tips that we use, and have a great deal of expertise drawn over many, many decades from all sorts of industries where they can give us essentially all of the empirical data that we need to be able to optimize the feeds, the speeds, and the cutting strategies that will allow us to get the very best out of these machines that we've invested in, driving the cycle times down and driving the quality and the cost to the best possible point that it can be. And perhaps one of the best examples of how we're doing that is the work that we're doing on our titanium compressor for the GT50 engine at the moment. So if we have a look at the example that we've got over here, essentially we take a billet of titanium and then turn it down on the lathe, and then eventually it goes onto the five axis over here, and we cut the blade forms, the curvet couplings, and various other details that we need to fit this into the engine. A lot of this development work, as you can see here, was done in aluminium because it's inexpensive and it allows us to optimize the cutting paths and the general work holding and all the other things that you have to do to be able to hold these parts on the machines and produce them effectively. The next thing that we have to do, which we're doing at the moment, is to move over into the flight grade materials and then optimize the feeds, the speeds, and make any tweaks that we need to the cutting strategy to produce these things efficiently in the relevant materials. Now, the challenge with that is the very performance that we're targeting with the GT50 engine makes huge demands of the compressor materials, and therefore we've been pushed up to a grade of titanium that is really rather difficult to cut effectively. And so we've been working with our tooling partner, Seco, to be able to optimize that cutting strategy. Because ordinarily what happens if you try and turn this titanium, it's very easy to find yourself in a position where rather than making chips that effectively carry the heat and the material that you've removed away from the part, you can make swarf, which is essentially extremely high strength, extremely abrasive wire that wraps around the tool, wraps around the machine, and makes a complete mess of the process. So in order to be able to manufacture this part in titanium effectively, we've had to develop a cutting strategy that uses the right feeds, the right speeds, the right depth of cut, the right tooling inserts, and importantly, high pressure coolant that rapidly chills the material as it cuts off, allowing it to break away and leave a clean cut with a high surface finish. Now, all of these materials have their own unique characteristics, and developing the detail of each of these processes is what allows us to control the costs in the program and what allows us to make sure that we can deliver HX50 and GT50 to the market to the price point. That's ultimately the power of vertical integration, but it also means that we have a very big job on our hands doing all of this in parallel with the design and development of the aircraft.
Since then, Seco have managed to increase the material removal rate to a point that we're now ready to create the first test-ready GT50 compressor. So if you enjoyed this video and want to see more, be sure to like and subscribe. And until next time, bye-bye.